Hey guys, so I want to do a quick follow-up on the gin and kombucha videos I made a few months ago. I don't remember when it was. I was trying to think about it because I want to tell you something about the kombucha. Well, the gin too, but... real quick. I'm about to decant my gin. It's ready. I don't even taste it, to be honest. I just know after 3 or 5 days of it sitting here, and now I let it go for 5 days. I used to only let it go for 3 days because... I don't know if you guys remember in my last gin video, I was kind of doing some troubleshooting. I was telling you it started smelling like vomit, which is gross. So, and basically, kombucha and gin, they make a lot of the same acids and things that are in your body and other places. So, I forgot, butyric acid, I think, is the one that smells kind of like vomit. So, it was just too much yeast, basically. So, I would just decant it. The next time, I put a little bit less honey in. It's just green tea and honey, of course, you're... stuff. I'll have the links to my video because I'm not going to explain all that right now. But so this is my gin. It's been 5 days. It doesn't ever smell like vomit anymore. So I don't know. I think maybe it was just maybe at the beginning kind of getting used to being in how I make it and the temperature here because, you know, I've got my starter, the SCOBY from, you know, Amazon. I don't know. And look how thick this SCOBY is on top. This is the starter one. I always put the same one. This is my mother's SCOBY from the very beginning, and I always use her. And then it makes a new one. And people are like, oh, Jen never makes a new SCOBY. And it does. It makes a SCOBY every time. And I've never tried to use it because I always just keep using the same one that I began with. And I just take this one off, throw it away. But I was saving some because it was $15 for that SCOBY. So I do have a SCOBY hotel of just Jen right here. I know it looks... freaky, but I just feed it every few weeks. I add a little more fresh tea, but look how thick that SCOBY is on the very top because I don't bother it. So there are some layers at the very bottom. That's the first down here is one of the SCOBYs I put in here. And as you can see, it creates another SCOBY. He's making more and more SCOBYs. So I don't know what people are talking about, but that way, if anything ever happens, I don't have to buy another one. I have some SCOBYs on reserve. So that's doing great. So today what I'm waiting for right now is for my green tea to cool off so I can add some honey to it and then start decanting my gin and start over with the fermentation process. These are the bottles that I'll be doing my second fermentation in. And again, they're just old. Most of these are Synergy or what's it called? No, that's the brand. Kavita? I don't remember. I only bought GTs like once or twice and it was basically so I can get a starter, right, for the kombucha. So this is gin. In these bottles, like this one, I have 2 cherries. I only put 2 cherries, and that's enough to make it really nice and flavorful. This one has Korean melon and ginger, and a Korean melon I picked up the other day at H Mart, and I was like, we're not eating it. Oh, you know what? I'll use it for my gin and my kombucha. It tastes just like cantaloupe honeydew. It's crispy, and it's interesting, and so I thought, you know what? I'll put my Korean melon in there. So some of them are just Korean melon, just, you know, a couple chunks. This is Jamaica, and if I put Jamaica, which is basically a hibiscus flower, I just keep it here all the time. I bought this at the Mexican store, and I bought a ton of it. So I just leave it here, and whenever I need it, I use it just like my tea. So I just grab a few petals of it, put it in there with a half a date, because you need something, some kind of sugar for it to eat in the second fermentation, or else it's not going to be fizzy. And my kombucha and my gin are explosive fizzy to where it's annoying, because, you know, I just redid my kitchen. And if it gets on the backsplash or something like that, I'm like, ah! So I'm really, sometimes I open it outside, but I've been doing it better in a way that it's not explosive, but it's fizzy, okay? So at the very beginning, it was always super fizzy. So I throw in half a date stuck up here and some Jamaica or hibiscus flower just to give it some sugar because it needs sugar. I've always noticed the most explosive ones are obviously your fruit ones and then ginger for whatever reason. So my kombucha's over here waiting for it to get done. I think I just did the kombucha 3 days ago, so it still needs some time, right, to ferment. But I've never separated the kombucha SCOBY because every time I make it, the SCOBY is so thin and small at the top, like, I don't care. It's still super fizzy. Look at this. I mean, look at the bubbles back up there. It's fizzy. It works. Look, you can still see bubbles even coming up right now as we're talking. And it always makes a really small, thin SCOBY, so I just keep it together. This is layered up, I don't even know how many times now. So I just want to show you that because I know with Kombucha Camp, I have their book right here. I love them. That's great. They want like $25, $30, however much it is for their SCOBY, some ridiculous number. And in their book, they tell you, oh, you don't want to make your own, you know, from bottle. And I think they even mentioned GT's as a brand. But because, you know, after a while, it's not going to work as well. And after maybe the 10th time you use it, I mean, I've used this how long? Months? Many months now. I'll have to check back on my old video when it was. And it's always fuzzy, or not fuzzy, we don't want it fuzzy. It's always fizzy and amazing. Like, the kombucha, has never gone wrong. It doesn't matter what I put in it to flavor it in the second fermentation or whatever, it's always good. And actually now we've gotten used to it just plain. So if I do plain kombucha for the second ferment, I'll get a bottle and I'll only put a date in there, half a date, because dates are pretty big. I put half a date in there. And not only because I like dates, I have raisins here too, because I had heard raisins are good. So I have raisins. This is just my little kombucha area. I got my honey going and everything. I'll put half a date, or you can put like maybe two or three raisins because they're smaller. And then just fill it up and then let it sit out for another 2 or 3 days, covered tightly, of course. I did want to mention some of these glasses. I got this from Amazon, and they sell this by Mokins brand, M-O-K-I-N-S, and I think that was 12 of them, and it came with a little filter and like a brush. And that's okay. They're good. The only thing is some people said, oh, I don't know, or like they shattered. So like this one got a crack in it. I know I can't see it right now. It's somewhere, it's like a hairline crack, but it scares me because I'm not going to put kombucha especially in here or Jen because, where is it? Oh, I think it's right there. Anyway, it's right there, this line. Because it'll shatter. But that's the only one that's done it. Out of 12, that's the only one that had a problem. So, you know, it didn't shatter. Obviously, it's here. But I just want to mention that. This I also got on Amazon. I got the dark colored ones too. There's a ton of them on there. If I have the link, I'll put them in the description box. It doesn't do me any good. Like, it's not going to... It's nothing. It's just that I'll put the link because that's what I bought. So I had bought these bottles and then I bought brown ones also. They've been really good. And another one that's good and I want to show you guys is the little Martinelli's. And Martinelli, I don't know, I've been drinking this stuff since I was a kid. The Martinelli's cider bottles, because we have some of these in my little fridge that I keep for the kids. The sparkling juice. And I thought, well, it's sparkling. I mean, it has some pressure, right? I'm going to try it. So I totally use these and the bottle cap reuses really easily. You just screw it back down. And it's been great. It keeps the fizz. They don't shatter. And they're a good size for the kids because it's a smaller amount. So I just want to mention that because some people say if you use beer bottles or old beer bottles, a lot of times those shatter too because beer just doesn't have the same pressure. Yeah, it's fizzy, but it's not fizzy like kombucha. So, you know, you want to be careful with that. So I do want to mention that those are good. And so, yeah, I mean, everything's been going great. It's been getting hotter right now. The kombucha's at 79 degrees in between 75 and 79. And I can feel it because I feel hot in here myself. You know, I live kind of near the, not super near the ocean, but near enough that I get that coastal breeze. So it's hard for me to, like, use the AC when we have such a nice breeze, but it's still, you know, in the house, it's like 75, 77, so this is a little warmer than, I guess because in this room, I don't ever open the window, so it's just what it is. So I just wanted to kind of follow up with you guys. What I'm going to do is maybe open a kombucha for you, because I haven't had some yet today while this is cooling off, because, like I said, I need it to cool down. It's, I don't even know how hot this is, because it's not even registering on the label, so that means it's above 90 degrees still. So I like to cool that down so I can put my honey and not kill the good things that are in the honey. And then before I go and decant all that. So let's go to my kitchen and I'll serve myself up some kombucha. Before I choose one, I want to show you guys how many bottles. There's some up here with the pickles I recently made. I had a video on that. I don't know how to make it, but I kind of talked about the cucumbers that are in my garden, which I have a ton more now too, so I might have to make more pickles even. The kombucha up there. There's some behind here, but this is a pie I just bought, so it's blocking all of these bottles as far back as I can see. It's all kombucha and Jun. Especially now that my husband's away for a military training, like, I try to get this in the kids. I try to drink it myself every day, at least one bottle, to get rid of at least 3 or 4 bottles a day, because literally every 5 to 7 days I'm making another batch of Jun or another batch of kombucha. So some of these are kind of old. Like, this is from June 26th. That's not old. July 7th. I try to bring the older ones forward. Put the new ones in the back. But like this mango Jun is from June 10th. And what I want to show you, well, let me see if I can. The longer you leave the Jun just chilling, just sitting, or your kombucha, it gets real clear. Like, I don't know if you can see how clear and perfectly beautiful this bottle is. This is pineapple Jun from June 4th. Oh, maybe I should have that one. I was going to open a kombucha because they're the more explosive ones. Yeah, let's do this cherry ginger. What is this? This kombucha. No, if I don't put J on here, then it's kombucha. So this is cherry ginger kombucha. It doesn't look like it's too fizzy. So let's just use that one because it's from July 1st. And we can do that. Okay, let me close this up. And, oh my goodness. I'm going to try to reset my camera so I can show you guys. Hopefully you can kind of see this. I have a nice clean glass here with some ice, and then I have this little strainer I ordered from Amazon. It's a set of 3. And what's funny enough, I already had one of these. I found it. So I don't know. It says Modi on it. If I have a link to that, I'll give you that, guys, too. So, cherry ginger, July 1st. Today is July 18th, I want to say. I don't know. So, like I said, I just made my ginger, I mean, my Jun. So, this is green tea that I had used. So, normally I don't shake it. I just wanted to show you that at the bottom, it's all silty. And it's because I put the fruit in there. You can always do a second fermentation in its own jar. Like, just put it in a mason jar or something big, you know, like a half-gallon jar. And let the fruit sit in there overnight for the next day, you know, at least 24 hours. And then take that, filter it out, and put it in its own individual bottles. Or leave it in that big jar. I have three big jugs in my fridge. I should have shown you guys from the GT Synergy, the big, big guy. Because everyone liked that, so I had those. So sometimes I'll do that too. But anyway, let's open this. And sometimes I find this like so impossible to open. Oh, look, here it comes. See? Can you see how it just... It's fizzy, 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 fizzy. And it's kind of, like, that was good because it wasn't explosive, but the fizz is kind of a pain, to be honest, because you have to wait for it to dissipate before you can really keep pouring, right? So this one's behaving. This is not too bad. But I already smell the ginger smell, and look, the cherries come out, like, with no color. And in Jun, it's even worse. See how it's kind of pale, and they're usually, like, bright red? But the Jun, they come out white. Whatever's in Jun, well, I know it's honey and green tea, but that... Yeast loves to just eat up that fruit. Whatever's in there, it just tears it up. Okay, so that's a big mess. Sorry, I have some dishes in my sink there and some cucumbers. All right, so good. And my daughter wanted a flower and then she brought it in because she puts it behind her ear sometimes, but she just put it there. Let me taste this. Oh my gosh, that is so yummy. You know what? I have some cherry Jun waiting. Maybe I'll throw some ginger in with it because that tastes really good. So thanks for watching. I hope that helps out. And like I said, I've been using the same starter that I made with the GT's bottle. You know what I'm saying? The same SCOBY that I got from that first time. Keep using that SCOBY. Keep using that SCOBY. And it's working just fine. So if you want to pay, you know, $2, $2.50 for a little bottle of GT's and start making your own kombucha and it costs you 70 cents, 80 cents to make a whole gallon of it every week, I think it's worth it. So thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you at the next one. Bye now.
You know I can never stop talking about this stuff, but I just want to show you. I still have a little bit left here. I'm still just... I put a pour spout on these guys, and I think I talked about that in the last video, but again, from Amazon, they're just stainless steel spouts. But look how pretty the colors look as you're even pouring them in there. And they'll get much brighter, especially the Jamaica ones, but look how cute and how clear, like, the little Korean one is. And you can see it already fizzes because it's already fizzy. Even just sitting here with, you know, with just breathing through the towel you put on top, it gets fizzy because of the fermentation, but we're going to give it a second ferment, get it super fizzy and super cute, and that's it. I just wanted to come back and show you guys that. All right, bye now.